Welcome back, students. Good morning to all. Myself, Sir Sunil, your physics teacher. And we are discussing nowadays the numerical parts from our unit first. Solved examples we have already discussed. And yesterday's section we have discussed from exercise till 10 the numericals. And same numericals part we are going to start our section today. Stay on video and all of you take out your book and watch the video carefully. Okay, students, we are going to start from question number 11. You please read out the question. A block of iron has dimensions 2 meter, 0.5 meter, 0.25 meter. The density of iron is given here, the density of iron that is given here, 7.8 gram per centimeter cube, that is equal to D. This is L, this is B, and this is H. Okay, what we have to find out? We have to find out mass, that is M we have to find out. By using this 3, L into B into H, we will get the answer V. Okay, students, then we can move through. See, as we told, L is given, B is given, and H is given, and density also given. Here one more thing you have to do. That is, we have to convert density into kilogram per meter cube. It is given in gram per centimeter cube. To convert kilogram per meter cube, what we have to do? We have to multiply by 1000. Then by multiplying this one, it will be changed in kilogram per meter cube. That is 7800 kilogram per meter cube. Now by using the relation L into B into H, as we have told earlier, we have to find out the volume V. Okay, mass is already given there. Sorry, mass is not given, density is given there. Okay, density is already given there. So by using the relation D is equal to M by V, M upon V, density D is equal to M upon V, we have to find out the relation M is equal to V into D. So how to find out mass? Mass we have to find out. Mass can be find out by this relation, volume into density. This both volume into density we know now. We now know the volume and density. So the volume is 0.25, okay, and the density, that is 7800 meter cube. So by multiplying these both, we'll get the answer 1950 kg. That is our final answer. Okay, students, you please mark it and write it. Now our question number 12. The mass of a lead piece is 1015 gram. Mass that is given. When it is immersed into a measuring cylinder, the water level rises from 20 ml mark to 30 ml mark. You should keep in your mind the final mark level of the water and initial level of the water. Okay, initial level and final level. You have to keep in your mind. And what we have to find out? The volume of the lead piece. First, you have to find out the volume of the lead piece, volume, then the density of the lead in kilogram per meter cube. We have to find out. Okay. Now, first of all, we are going to write what are the things given in the question. In each and every question, you have to write like this: what are the points, what are the hints, what are the measurements given in the question. Here it is given, M is equal to 115 gram. M is equal to mass, then V1, the initial level as I told you, then V2, that is final level, that is 30 ml. V1 is 20 ml, V2 is 30 ml. Then how to find out V2 minus V1? Clear? We know that. The theory part we have already discussed, and some questions we have done also in example questions. Okay, that volume of lead piece can be find out by this relation V2 minus V1. Final level minus initial level. Here it is final level, that is 30 ml. Initial level 20 ml. 30 minus 20 is equal to 10 ml, that is 10 centimeter cube. Why we are writing 10 centimeter cube? 10 ml is equal to 10 centimeter cube because 1 ml is equal to 1 centimeter cube. Okay, students. Now we got the volume V. Volume V got it. That is 10 ml or 10 centimeter cube. Now we have to find out the density of lead piece. Then density, to find out density, we know the relation D is equal to M upon V. Okay, mass is given there, that is 115. We have already found here 10 centimeter cube. So 115 divided by 10 centimeter cube is equal to 11.5 gram per centimeter cube. So we know that. One more thing in theory we have discussed. 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, that's why here we have to multiply, then we will get a kilogram per meter cube. 11.5 multiply by 1000, then we will get the final answer 11,500 kilogram per meter cube. Then problem is solved. Now our question number 13. The density of copper is 8.9 gram per centimeter cube. What will be its density in kilogram per meter cube? We have to convert this gram per centimeter cube into kilogram per centimeter cube. We know that very easy question it is. How to convert? Multiply by 1000. Just now only we have done. Okay, students, density of copper rod, that is given here in the question. D is equal to 8.9 gram per centimeter cube. By multiplying this value into 1000, we will get the answer, the final answer, 8900 kilogram per meter cube. As given in the previous question, we know that 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, students, very easy. Now, question number 14. A car travels distance of 15 km in 20 minutes. Distance and time is given. Find the speed of the car. Find the speed of the car. Okay. In kilometer per hour and meter per second. Okay. Here also, same way we have to write what are the measurements given in the question. Distance traveled by a car. Distance, that is equal to 15 km. Time, that is equal to 20 minutes. Speed of the car in kilometer per hour. We have to convert. First question it is speed of the car in kilometer per hour. Converts 20 minutes to hour. First of all, we have to convert 20 minutes to hour. So we know that 1 minute is equal to 1 upon 60 hour. Then 20 minutes is equal to 1 into 20 upon 60, that is equal to 1 upon 3 hour. Okay, 1 upon 3 hour, convert it is minutes into hour. So now we know that the relation to find out the speed of the car, the speed is equal to distance upon time, d upon t, we know that. So here the distance is given, that is 15 kilometer is the distance. Time already we know now, that is 1/3 hour. Okay, by calculating this one, by cross multiplication, we can understand that 15 into 3, that is equal to 45 kilometer per hour. You're getting the answer. Okay, now we have to convert this one into meter per second. For that, we have to convert this one into 15 kilometer into meters. We know that 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. We know that 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter it is. So 15 kilometer is equal to 1000 into 15, that is equal to 15,000 meter. Convert minutes into seconds then. Convert minutes into seconds. We know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So what about 20 minutes? 20 minutes is equal to 60 into 20, that is equal to 1200 seconds. So speed of the car is equal to distance upon time. We know that distance, speed of the car is equal to d upon t, Now we know that distance that is equal to 15,000 meter and the time that is 1,200 seconds. By dividing these both, we'll get the final answer 12.5 meter per second. That is final. Okay, now we are going to discuss about question number 15. You please read out the question. How long a train will take to travel a distance of 200 kilometer? 200 kilometer distance that is given, 200 kilometer, and here it is given the speed. Distance and speed is given. What we have to find out? Time we have to find out. Time. So as previous question, we have to write what are the points given here in the question. First one, distance is given, then speed is given. Okay, distance is 200 kilometer and speed is 60 kilometer per hour. Okay students, now we know that speed is equal to speed. How we'll find out? Speed is equal to distance upon time. Speed is equal to distance upon time. So 60 is equal to speed is 60 is equal to 200 upon time. Speed is 60 and distance is 200 divided by time. Then from this we'll get time is equal to 200 upon 60, that 20 upon 60, that is equal to 3 upon 10 hours. Okay, by cancelling this one, clear? Then 3, then 10, we'll get the answer. Time is 10 upon 3 hours. Means convert this one into mixed fraction. Okay, we know that in maths how to convert this one in mixed fractions. This into mixed fraction will get 3 whole 1 by 3 hours. That is equal to 3 hour plus 1 by 3 hours. That can be written as 3 hour plus 1 by 3 hour into 60 minutes. Clear? 3 20, that is 20 minutes. 3 hour plus 20 minutes, that is given the final answer, that is 3 hour 20 minutes. Okay students, now we are going to discuss the question number 16. Question number 16, a boy travels with a speed of 10 meter per second. The speed is given here, that is 10 meter per second for 30 minutes. Speed is given, that is 10 meter per second for 30 minutes. Time also given. How much distance? I have to find out here the distance. So every question we have to write the hints given in the question, means the points given in the question. Here also, speed of the boy, that is 10 meter per second. Time taken, that is 30 minutes. Okay, we have written. Then speed is equal to distance traveled upon time taken, distance upon time, we know that. So how to find out the distance? Distance is equal to speed into time. Distance is equal to speed into time. Here what we have to do, convert 30 minutes to seconds. Convert 30 minutes to seconds. We know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Then 30 minute is equal to 60 into 30. 60 into 30. 30 minutes is equal to 60 into 30. That is equal to 1800 seconds. That is equal to 1800 seconds. Okay. 30 minute is equal to 1800 seconds. Putting the value of speed and time, we get distance traveled is equal to 10 meter second into 1800 second, that is equal to 18,000 meter. 18,000 meter or 18 kilometer. Clear? By dividing by 1000, will get the answer final, that is 18 kilometer. Okay students, now we are going to discuss about the question number 17. Express 36 kilometer per hour into meter per second. Okay, we know that 36 kilometer per hour is equal to 36 into 1000 divided by 60 into 60. This is the relation, that is equal to 10 meter per second. Just do like this. Now question number 18. Express 15 meter per second in kilometer per hour. We know that 1 meter is equal to 1 upon 1000 kilometer. 15 meter is equal to 15 upon 1000 kilometer. Okay, please write it. And also we know that 1 second is equal to 1 upon 3600 hour. Here distance is equal to 15 upon 1000 kilometer. Already we know time is 1 upon 3600 hour. Okay, so what is the speed? Speed is equal to distance upon time. Distance already given there, that is 15 upon 1000, and the time is given 1 upon 3600. By cross multiplying we'll get 15, and this one will get 15 upon 1000 into 3600 upon 1. The final answer is, by calculating this one, we'll get the answer 54 kilometer per hour. Okay students, so this is our final question. Okay, our numericals part is going to complete today. So we are going to wind up today's section. Okay, welcome back students. Already we have discussed the numericals. Okay, numerical part is over. It's a time to wind up our session. Okay, practice the numericals. Today I have given the homework in your NLP platform. I hope that you are practicing the questions. And now our question answers part is left out, and question answers will be given to you. Always check the PDF documents in the NLP platform. It will be given early. Okay. Okay, today I'm going to wind up. Goodbye and have a nice day.